From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. A Bahamian digital payments provider has hit back at mounting attacks on its business by asserting that all contracts were won above board, its chairman adding, "I have absolutely nothing to hide." Nicholas Rees branded the politically led assault on Canoe as inaccurate, reckless, and laden with ulterior motives, and warned they threatened to undermine not just the company, but national world-first initiatives such as the launch of the central bank's sand dollar digital currency, confirming that Canoe has also won the bid to provide the multi-signature digital wallets to all government departments and agencies so that they can use the sand dollar for payment transactions. Mr. Rees said the past 2 weeks have made him question whether it was really worth coming home if this is how the country is going to treat me and my co-founders. Pick up a copy of today's Tribune for more on this story. Former Deputy Prime Minister Cynthia Mother Pratt has tested positive for COVID-19. In an interview with the Tribune yesterday, the former Member of Parliament said she suspected she had the virus after experiencing nausea and fatigue a week ago. Mrs. Pratt followed up with a COVID-19 test, which confirmed her suspicions. The former St. Cecilia MP has also experienced loss of taste and smell, telltale signs of a coronavirus infection in many cases. Mrs. Pratt, who is in quarantine at her home, urged Bahamians to take the proper precautions to avoid the disease. A 7 p.m. to 5 a.m. curfew has been implemented for North and South Bimini in response to a COVID-19 outbreak on that island. An amendment to the Emergency Powers Order says funerals can be held at the graveside only, but no more than 10 people, not including officiants or funeral workers, are allowed to attend the services. Weddings are permitted in a church, facility, or outdoors once the number of attendees does not exceed 10, including the officiant, and all attendees wear masks. Wedding receptions and repasts are prohibited on the island. Wedding hosts who contravene the rules could be liable upon conviction to a $2,000 fine, and in the case of an attendee, a $300 fine. Tropical Storm Elsa has upgraded to a Category 1 hurricane today, according to weather officials. AccuWeather noted this is the first Atlantic hurricane for the year. The system was also the fifth named storm of 2021. The storm upgraded to a hurricane at around 8 a.m. this morning, and maximum sustained winds have increased to 75 miles per hour, but the movement has not changed much. It's still moving west-northwest at around 28 miles per hour and will move just to the south of Hispaniola sometime on Saturday morning, moving well to the north of the southeast Bahamas on Sunday morning, and passing over central Cuba and into the Florida Straits sometime by Tuesday morning. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, the number of people missing in the Florida condominium collapse fell substantially today, from 145 to 128, after duplicate names were eliminated and some residents reported missing turned up safe, officials have said. Authorities also announced the recovery of two more bodies, including the 7-year-old daughter of a Miami firefighter. That raised the confirmed death toll to 20 people. Miami-Dade Mayor Daniela Levine Cava said the number of missing declined following an audit. She explained that in some cases, one person may have been moved to the accounted for list when, in fact, an entire family had been found safe. Driven by the Delta variant, a new wave of COVID-19 is sweeping across the African continent, where new cases, hospital admissions, and deaths are increasing. The speed and scale of Africa's third wave is like nothing we've seen before, the WHO's regional director of Africa has said. South Africa is leading the new surge in Africa, where case numbers are doubling every 3 weeks, according to the World Health Organization. The Delta variant, reported in 16 African countries, has become dominant in South Africa, which accounts for more than half of Africa's new cases. It was detected that 97% of samples sequenced in Uganda and in 79% of samples sequenced in Congo, said the WHO. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. A moist and unstable air mass will continue to support a broad area of unsettled weather across the northwest and central Bahamas. Meanwhile, high pressure will maintain moderate to fresh winds across the central and southeast Bahamas. Boaters and residents should remain vigilant for possible waterspout or tornadic activity. Localized flooding is also possible during heavy and or prolonged rainfall events. Beachgoers in the central and south southeast Bahamas should exercise caution due to the risk of rip currents at east and south coast beaches. For the northwest and central Bahamas, it'll be mostly cloudy to overcast and a bit breezy, mainly in the central Bahamas, with widely scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms through tonight. Some showers may be heavy and thunderstorms strong to severe at times. A small craft caution remains in effect for the central Bahamas. Small craft operators should also be alert for gusty winds and higher seas in or near heavy showers and thunderstorms. Winds southeast to south at 10 to 15 knots in the northwest Bahamas and southeasterly at 15 to 20 knots over open waters in the central Bahamas. Seas 2 to 4 feet in the northwest Bahamas and 4 to 7 feet over the ocean in the central Bahamas. For the southeast Bahamas, it'll be partly cloudy and breezy with a few passing showers and the chance of an isolated thunderstorm this afternoon. Mostly fair and breezy tonight. A small craft caution is in effect. Winds east to southeast at 15 to 20 knots, but gusty at times over open waters. Seas 4 to 7 feet, but higher in gusts over the ocean. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 88 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 72. The sun will set this afternoon at 8:02 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:25. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets, or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.